Welcome. So we're on day two for the Kundalini, and this kriya is called to adjust the heat in the body for improved digestion and weight loss. So we'll start by tuning in. Sit tall, engage the bandhas, gaze towards the third eye, center of the forehead. Take a deep inhale, full exhale. Inhale, out and up with your arms. Exhale, hands at your heart. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. Inhale deeply. Hold your inhale. Bring your hands to your knees. Start with some deep, full breathing. Breathing into your abdomen, ribs, upper chest. Sit tall, lift your heart. Close your eyes, focus at the breath. Let each part expand as you inhale, contract as you exhale. Three full inhales and full exhales. And then take a big inhale, hold your inhale. Squeeze gently the root up, then exhale. Bring your arms up, fingers in, thumbs out. This opens up the heart and the ribs and the diaphragm. This is called ego eradicator. Use the breath of fire. Keep going, keep lifting up your heart, let your shoulder blades slide down your back. Inhale, touch the thumbs without looking. Hold the inhale. And exhale, relax your hands down to your knees. Notice the effects of the breath of fire. So an expanding breath now. So you use bellows breath, and as you inhale, stretch your arms forward, hands are clasped. And as you exhale, in towards you. And sit tall, let's go. Thank you. exhale, bring your hands back to your knees. And take a few breaths to feel the effects. Now change your ankles over if you want to, or do a square breath. So sit comfortably. You can have your hands in Gyan Mudra on your knees. And then inhale for four counts. Hold that inhale for four. Exhale for four. And hold out your exhale for four. So that's one round of square breath. You want to keep going and gradually slow down your count. Sitting tall. Roll forward to the front of your sit bones. Sit tall, press the backs of your legs to the floor. Bring palms together, inhale left, exhale right. Lift your heart up. Keep reaching up long the spine. working for your flexibility as well. Tall on the spine, reach up, ground, put the sit bones into the floor, and exhale, leaning forward, reach towards the feet if you can, or the legs or the ankles. Then just lowering your head down, rest in this position for a few deep breaths. Lie onto your back and do some gentle pelvic tilts to start with. Tilt this down a little. Okay, so lying on your back, some pelvic tilts. Inhale up, exhale down, and gradually make the tilts higher. And then eventually come up into a bridge. Feet parallel, clasp your hands and lift a little higher, tuck your arms underneath your shoulders, lift, big inhale, full exhale. If you're stable in your lower spine, and only if you feel stable, then you can lift right knee towards you and bring the toe up to the ceiling, and then knee towards you and foot down, and then switch legs. But make sure you remain very stable in your lower back, otherwise just stay here with the shoulders pressing into the back. So if you're stable, bring the knee towards you and then stretch the toes up. Your hips up a little bit higher again, and then slowly release your hands and slowly bring your spine to the floor, come up to you, sitting, bring your hands on your knees and big circle, so inhale forward and exhale circling back. Let the shoulders open up and broaden. Let your spine be long and tall. After center switch. center, bring your hands back onto your knees. So whatever leg is forward, you're gonna lift up same arm as the leg and stretch up and back and then back to the floor. And again, that same side, stretch up and back. And then exhale to the floor. Again, that same side. And two more. Resting on your shins. So make sure you travel up your spine on your inhale and travel back down on your exhale. Continue. Together, bring your knees together, rest your hands on your thighs above the knee and circle your hips and let that cat and cow movement go with the hips as well, the natural movement of your spine. So inhale, back your spine flexes, exhale forward, your spine rounds, arches. Thank you. Continue, strong breath. Sure, your spine is tall, your sacrum relaxed, your shoulders relaxed, fingers and thumbs up. So you're holding the bow, pull back the bow, make sure your elbow is level with your shoulder, have your knee above your ankle. Set your gaze firmly beyond the thumb into the middle distance. Get ready for the breath of fire. Okay, so big inhale. Begin. Decide where to send the arrow, and as you exhale, shoot. And switch your legs over. Strong, steady stance. Relaxed. Tail dropping straight down. Fix your gaze. Pull back the bow. Elbow lifted. Lift your heart. And begin. Inhale, squeeze the bandhas, and be ready to send the arrow. You create your destiny, you decide. So we're going to come back down to the floor to open up the back a little bit more because the kriya requires this. So you're going to go into, first of all, the locus and then a bow. So lie on your front. Let your arms go up and back behind. If you can, keep the feet together and lift the legs as well. Stretch the heart forward, stretch your toes back. And lift and stretch. Big inhale, and keep stretching as you exhale down. This time, come into a cobra. So you're going to stretch the toes back, your tail reaching back, your heart reaches forward. And lengthen your lower spine. Draw open your shoulders. Big inhale. One exhale. your feet, if you can, take hold of your ankles. Either stay there with your heart reaching forward, or kick into your hands and peel your thighs off the floor. Breathe. Keep reaching your heart forward, keep active legs. Big inhale, stretch, and exhale, slow down. Really press away the floor with your hands, and bring yourself to sitting on your heels. We'll start the Kriya now. It's the Kriya to adjust the heat in the body for improved digestion and weight loss. So, starts with camel. So if you want to do a modified camel to start with, it recommends 11 minutes, but we'll just do between 1 and 3 minutes to start, because it's a lot to do suddenly, especially back bends now. So, okay, let's put the timer. So you're reaching up, slide your shoulder blades down your back, press your fingers into your lower back, or your palms, fingers face upwards. Slight gap between your knees. Keep pushing your hips forward. Open up your heart and let your shoulders relax back. Either have your head on your chin, or if you can, lean the head back as well. You'll just be here breathing normally, as long as you can manage. And then if possible for you, you can bring your fingertips to your heels, but you need to keep pushing your hips forward. So push hips forward. Let the head drop back and breathe. Long, full breathing. Just over a minute there, so try and slowly build that up to 3 minutes, and eventually 11 minutes is the aim, but don't push it. The next posture is to sit in rock pose. It's called rock pose because Yogi Bhajan says you could digest rocks if you sit in this posture. So it's just on your heels with your hands on your knees, and to sit in rock pose. And just keep the spine straight. Breathe deeply. Bring your inward gaze to the third eye. Your aim is to build up to 11 minutes, but we'll do the same amount of time as we did with the other exercise, so just over a minute. Straight spine. So the fire in you that keeps you with strong digestion. You digest your food, but also it lets you digest the experiences of the world. So each thought and emotion must be processed. And with this inner heat, everything is tasty and life is a joy. Yogi Bhajan says, live and let live and enjoy it, experience it. So we need this fire, the digestive fire, to enjoy our food, but also to enjoy the experiences of life. So the final posture in this short kriya is to lie in child's pose with your arms tucked along your sides. You just bring your forehead to the floor if you can, or on a cushion. And we'll do the same amount of time, minute and a half. The same breathing, just long, full breathing. Sit again in Sukhasana. So that's it, that's the whole kriya. The idea is that you build up gradually. So next time you do it, try 3 minutes.